In today's video, you'll learn 15 incredibly useful Asana tips and tricks which you can use today to improve your productivity, make your workflow a whole lot smoother, and overall get more done. Ready? Let's do this. Hi, lovely people, it's Natalia and welcome back to my channel where I help you create better content and grow on social media. Asana is one of the best free productivity tools out there and today you'll learn how to use it better. Let's start with the first tip, my absolute favorite little gem hidden within the Asana desktop app, and that's the Pomodoro timer. Did you know that there's an inbuilt timer that you can use each time you work on a specific task in Asana? It's brilliant because it helps you focus and actually finish the task much quicker. I've talked about working with a timer in my productivity hacks for consistent content video. You can watch it next. And it's one of those small tricks that helps you get so much more efficient. Of course, Asana thought of that too, but not many people know that it's actually there. To find it, open the desktop app of Asana. It needs to be the desktop version rather than the browser version. Go to your tray at the bottom and click the Asana logo. From here, you'll see the preview of all of your different tasks from the My Tasks view. So choose the one you'll be focusing on right now and click start. A standard 25-minute Pomodoro timer will start, helping you concentrate much better. You can also turn on Do Not Disturb to mute any notifications. The timer gets minimized if you click away. You can always get back to it by clicking on it here at the bottom. And from here, you can also pause the timer too if there's something that does distract you. Tip number two, add custom views. Asana is so fantastic because of the flexibility it gives us with all the different types of views we have for the project. You can add filters or sort your tasks to work the way you like, which can also be saved for that view so you don't need to fuff about and repeat the settings each time. But what if you want more of that same view but with different settings? Well, you can add custom views too. To do this, go here to the views panel and click the plus sign right here. Choose the type of a view that you want. I'll choose board in this case. And from here, a new tab will appear for this one. If you then click away and click on the three dots right next to it, you'll be able to rename it. I'll just say Nat. And from here, you'll also be able to reposition it. This is super useful to not mix things up between the same views. Now, once you add your filters, I'll just filter it from a different assignee. So I'll just choose my own. And you will be able to just save it in here like this and enjoy your custom view with specific tasks that you want to see. So, so useful. Tip number three, show appreciation. Working with a team is fun, but can also be quite challenging at times. That's why it's so important to show appreciation to your employees or your teammates, and it's super easy to do in Asana too. When someone's doing a great job, you can go to a task they're working on, scroll down to the comments section, and actually click this icon right here. You'll be able to choose a sticker, and once you post it, it will say that you've shown appreciation. It's a fun way to thank someone for, you know, doing that extra little bit for you, attaching a crucial file for you despite being busy, for giving you a great suggestion, or for finishing something earlier than expected. Tip number four, print projects. Although Asana is a fabulous tool to stay on top of your daily operations, those of you who still like that pen to paper experience with tasks and planning can feel like there's something missing. And I think this tip is a great bridge between the digital and the analog. You can actually print your tasks both from your projects and from the My Tasks view. It's great when you want a physical to-do list to still be able to tick things off of it. To do this, go to My Tasks or any of your projects, pull up the drop-down menu and hit print or export print if it's a project. You'll be able to actually print a list that's sorted into your existing sections, which is super cool if you're printing a weekly to-do list from My Tasks view. Tip number five, use shortcuts. Making your workflow quicker is crucial in any app, and shortcuts always play a huge part in increasing efficiency. Start using shortcuts in Asana and you'll see how effortless the whole process becomes. You can then focus on the important things and let the creativity flow. When you're adding tasks one by one, you can just keep hitting enter instead of finding the plus sign or going to the add task button. To complete a task, simply click control and enter. Deleting tasks is super easy too, because you can just hit tab and backspace on the selected tasks. I love how the planning process is so much easier this way, because I can just add multiple tasks one by hitting enter, and then I can just select them and hit tab M to assign them to myself. By the way, tab A will open up the assignee window so you can start typing someone else's name too. Then tab D helps you set a due date quickly, and then tab Z takes you to My Task to Manager workflow easily. Fewer clicks means more efficiency since you're not really losing those precious minutes on managing Asana itself. Tip number 6, favorite projects. One of the best ways to always have everything you need at hand is to star your favorite projects. It allows you for super easy maneuvering when juggling multiple tasks or currently focusing on a bunch of projects like a product launch or an active partnership. To do this, go to one of your most used projects, and then you can start from the top right here. Once you do it, a new section with all of your star projects appears in the left panel, and I love it because no matter how many different teams you're a part of, you can quickly jump to your favorites with just a click. FYI, to remove it, you can just click on that star again or right-click your projects from the start section and then hit remove from start. Tip number 7, task covers. Do you know those awesome Trello style card covers that make everything look so aesthetic? Well, you can do the same thing with your Asana projects. Not only is it useful for quickly identifying what the task is without even having to read the title, but it's also a great way to divide your project further, to decorate it, or even mark specific tasks as master tasks to duplicate. To do this, simply get into the task and attach a file you want to use as a cover. It can be done by dragging and dropping into the task, or you can simply copy something from your clipboard and just paste it straight into the description. The best part is Asana lets you choose your cover if you have multiple files attached. Right-click your task, go to Choose Cover Image, and choose the image that you want to use. As a default, it's always the most recent one. From here, you can also decide against using a cover at all, and you can just go to show no image. Tip number 8, create tasks outside of Asana. Did you know you can create tasks outside of Asana? When you're on the go or creating content outside, you can quickly add new tasks to different projects in many super simple ways. One of my favorite ones is email, since we all spend quite a bit of time within our inboxes. First, you need to make sure that you're all set for this feature to work, so go to your settings from the profile pic in the top right corner, and then go to the email forwarding tab. Here, everything is explained to you in detail, so you see that you can simply email a new task from your Asana associated email to x@mail.asana.com. And mind you, X is an actual X, not your name, not your username, or anything like that. It's just universal since Asana connects the sender's email with the Asana account. Take a look at this section first and make sure that your email right here is allowed to create tasks and messages for the workspace, which in my case is nataliakalinska.com. Before you send that email, make sure you understand how Asana interprets it. The recipient, of course, is x@mail.asana.com. The email subject becomes a task name. Any recipients that you CC on that email are task collaborators. The email body becomes a task description, and the email attachments actually then are attached to the tasks. So incredible. It then lands in your recently assigned, and from here you can assign a due date and add it to a specific project. I'll just go to the weekly planning for this one. As an example, when I receive an email inquiry for a consultation, I can just quickly pop a new task to follow up on my Asana workspace, and it opens up a whole workflow for me, so nothing important ever gets missed. Another way to create a task outside of Asana is via Slack. If you're a Slack user, you can easily add new tasks as you chat along with others, so again, the workflow gets so much easier and nothing slips through the cracks. You don't have to jump between apps and fill out all the different details, it can just be done in one place. When you're on the go, out shopping, or cleaning up at home, and you suddenly remember something that you actually have to do, you can just ask Siri or ask a Google Assistant to create a task through your phone, as long as you have the Asana app installed. And there's also the Asana Chrome extension, which allows you to add a task with one click without having to leave whatever tabs you're in. Tip number 9, create recurring tasks for theme days. One of my favorite ways to stay consistent with content creation and function more efficiently within my business is to work with themed days. If you don't know what this concept is about, it's basically when your whole day revolves around one type of activity, like a script day, like a recording day, a product day, etc. I talk about it in greater detail in this video right here, so make sure you watch it next. Asana is fantastic in supporting the system, and I love to use recurring tasks for those repeated activities I do on any given day. For a recording day, it can be something like record a YouTube video, record X amount of reels, and capture 5 lifestyle B-roll clips from my setup, me working on my phone, my laptop, etc. To set up a recurring task, create and describe what you repeatedly do. Let's say prep for recording for this one, and then select a due date. I'll choose today. Below, click on this arrow icon right here and set to repeat. You can then choose different patterns like daily, weekly, monthly, yearly, or you can go for periodically, which is quite an interesting one where it lets you choose days after completion, or you can go for custom for more tailored schedules. Tip number 10, section your subtasks. When you have bigger tasks like publishing a YouTube video, for example, they usually include a lot of smaller subtasks that happen in different stages. When you add all of those subtasks, it sometimes becomes quite clunky and not really easily distinguishable. One of my favorite ways to organize big tasks even better is to add sections to my subtasks, and here's where one of my trusty shortcuts comes to play. To do this, click on any of your subtasks and go to tab N to create a new section. Give it a name, I'll go for export, then reposition it, hit tab N again, and repeat the process. Instead of a messy list of unstructured subtasks, you end up with a beautifully sectioned list that helps you focus better and increases productivity since you're working in defined stages. Love this one. Tip number 11, use dependencies. Staying on the subject of big tasks, sometimes things can't really progress unless something else is completed, right? For example, I wouldn't be able to publish a YouTube video unless it was actually edited. I wouldn't be able to edit unless I had previously recorded, and so it goes. To add an extra level of efficiency and oversight, especially when you're working within bigger teams, you can create dependencies within your tasks. To do this, go to a task that's dependent on another. Click the 3 dots and choose Add Dependencies. Another tab appears in our field section, and when you click it, you can begin typing the name of the task you want to be the precedent task, so the one that this current task is dependent on. It will then show right next to blocked by, indicating its dependency. By the way, you can keep adding those since a single task can be dependent on multiple tasks, and multiple tasks can be dependent on a single task. You won't be able to complete it unless the precedent one gets done. There's a whole layer of notifications connected to this feature. And what I also love about it is that you can choose for the due dates to auto shift when something changes with the precedent task. Very, very useful. And just an FYI, it is a premium feature, so you won't be able to use it on a free plan, but it's well worth a try to see if it works for your business and team. When you're a premium user, you're also able to draw out those dependencies within timeline view, which is super helpful to manage time-restricted collaborative projects. Tip number 12, add integrations. Not sure if you realize this, but Asana has quite a few useful integrations that can help with your workflow and frankly make your life that much easier. I personally use it all the time to reference my content dashboard in Notion without having to go to the specific page and then find the video or the post that I'm focusing on. Another classic in here is the Google Drive connection. I can just attach my files straight into a project or a task without having to download anything and then upload it there from my drive. They land in Asana with no hassle and they can be used by anyone else. By the way, you can do the same thing with OneDrive or Dropbox. And there are so many other options. You can monitor your email campaign metrics with MailChimp. You can reference key lead details with Salesforce and do both of these with HubSpot. If you work with clients or rely on meetings, you can connect your Asana to Zoom or Microsoft Teams and create or link meetings straight from Asana. You can also add tasks on the go within meetings and take notes right into your workspace or even attach transcripts into tasks. I'm all about improving your systems and making sure you're that much more efficient, and it definitely helps when you have so many integrations available within Asana. To check them all out, go to a project and then customize in the top right corner in here, then scroll to apps right here. You can browse some of the integrations that Asana has available or search the bar if you have something specific in in mind like this, and when you click, you'll get more details in there too. Tip number 13, mention tasks for reference. Something that I really love in Asana is that you can reference pretty much anything you like in the project or task descriptions. It's so useful in many different contexts. When you add a task to create content for the week, you can quickly reference the actual pieces of content in the description from your content calendar. If you're falling behind and need to catch up, it can reference all the crucial activities that require your immediate attention. Same goes for, you know, checking KPIs or updating project status. It's so easy to just mention the tasks or the areas that need to be revised without leaving the other person to figure out the actions themselves. To do this, go to the task description and hit at. This pulls up a field so that you can start typing your task name, project name, or even a specific person. For example, I can say record in here, and you'll be able to reference all of those previous tasks that you've added to Asana. Tip 14, record in tasks. Did you know you can record into tasks in Asana? Let me show you. Go to a task, scroll to the description, and click this recording icon right here. A panel opens up, giving you a choice between recording just the screen, just your camera, or both. You can select your camera and a microphone and start recording. Then you can choose the screen, the window, or the Chrome tab. Once you're done, your video will get uploaded, and you can change the title here too. By the way, without connecting your Asana to a Vimeo account, you have a limit of 2 videos, but you can create a free Vimeo account, which gives you a total storage space of 5 GB, and this is what it looks like when it's published. It's super useful for things like tutorials, walkthroughs, or brain dumps, and a simple example in here would be if I were to outsource repurposing my YouTube content into shorts to an assistant. I can record a video within Canva, guiding her through the process. If I'd be coming up with ideas for a video, I could just record myself unloading anything that comes to mind for the subject so that I can easily reference it when I script. FYI, if you can't see this feature in Asana, it might be because you're using the desktop app. As far as I know, currently recording into tasks is only available through the browser. Tip 15, bulk update. This tip helps when you're going through many tasks at once and need to update them all in Asana. You don't have to manually change things one by one. In Asana, you can actually perform bulk actions. To do this, simply select all of your tasks from either the My Tasks view or within a list view in a project by clicking one, then holding Shift and clicking the last one. You can also hold Control to add another one to the selection. Once you have it, you can tick one to complete all of them. Alternatively, you can use the panel below for other bulk actions like editing a project, updating the due date or an assignee, and many, many others. I love using it during my planning sessions to quickly spread the tasks out, and for my theme days when I go through different tasks all at once and don't necessarily tick them off one by one. If you'd like to learn how to use theme days and find out what my favorite 4 productivity tips are for creating consistent content, then make sure you watch this video right here. If you have any Asana or non-Asana questions, drop them down below. I always try to help as much as I can. Hit that like button if you've enjoyed this video. Subscribe for more content like this. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.